Ladies and gentlemen, Bill DeMott.
Money. May I say what happened great matchup.
And therefore,
let's send a guy in the suitcase.
Where's their man here?
Oh, look at that suitcase machine wants to know. Let's send a guy over there.
Wait, what the heck is going on here? Is this red rum?
I know that music. I know.
Really? Who?
I believe that is
who. Oh my god, no.
We just have to see who.
Alright, I'm gonna go hide out somewhere right now, guys. Like, don't mind me.
I don't
he
think.
He hails from the depths of hell.
Switch it is for Shadow Fox to go tagging with the man from the heavens, the prophet, to going from the man from hell, Relic.
I don't even know what to say right now, guys. I really don't.
I see a couple scared little kids in the crowd. That's what I see.
I see a couple scared guys on the side of the ring.
I see a scared guy in the camera right now.
Oh, man.
Rey Mysterio's really not sure what to make of the whole situation. He looks like a scared 13-year-old boy at the time.
He's trying to figure out what he got himself into dealing with these guys now this.
I mean, I didn't hear anything about this. Did you cast Lucius?
I had no idea.
You're the owner. Are you telling me you had no idea this guy was coming out?
I knew something was up for tonight, but I didn't know it was going to be a Relic. It definitely was not slitting past me.
Unbelievable. I bet you right now, Mosh Pit Mike and Basura over there are feeling a little bit down because Cedric the Hitman did not tell him about Relic coming out here.
I'm pretty sure Cedric the Hitman threw some money their way.
Yeah, but does money pay for a funeral?
No, not much.
You think he's got something in that suitcase to back off Relic? You think that's why he's holding that suitcase so closely?
Yeah,
I want to know what's in there.
You know, whatever's in there, it ain't going to stop Relic.
I think whatever's in there has got his boy staying there, too, so it must be something to keep him by this ring. Because I don't know about you, but they paid me a lot.
Oh, look at Mosh Pit Mike! Mosh Pit Mike went right to the outside! He's like, yeah, that what you got?
Wow, he said he's not getting paid enough. Come on, ref, get him in the ring. Let's start this match.
Man, Relic just awaits.
You know, Mosh Pit Mike's claim to fame is that he can wrestle. Although the fans seem to tell him about every 3.5 seconds that he's the worst wrestler on the planet Earth.
I can't agree or disagree with the fans on that, because I've seen where Mosh Pit
right
Mike,
now they're chanting, "You can't wrestle."
He almost just fell
apparently
off the
he can't climb the ropes yep. either.
Well, I don't think this is going to be as much as a wrestling match as it is. Oh, wait a second. Relic stepping out.
Oh, we got
Lucha Star stepping in.
Wow.
Lucha Star, huh?
Look at the size difference in these two, ladies and
That's
gentlemen.
That's at least 200 pounds.
I was just going to say, he's like a buckle five soaking
dude,
wet
I got 50
with sand
bucks.
In his pocket.
I like to bet. I got 50 bucks Lucha outpowers Monstrous Mike.
Yeah, that's a you're a dangerous betting man right there. You're a dangerous
I'm
betting
feeling
man.
It tonight, brother.
I'd like to say
right
odds
now.
In Vegas on this one.
Whoa.
Oh, Lucha Stark.
Wow.
To the car.
All right, I just lost $50.
Looks like Relic's got some business outside the ring with that little girl he made cry over there.
My lord. He just went running towards her at about 100 miles an hour.
That's a scary individual.
Man,
I'll tell
man.
You what.
Lock up the game. Lucha Stark trying to lock up
the
right to the ground.
Wow.
Boy, he got right back up.
Oh, look at the power of the Lucha Ring.
Oh, man.
Brother, those Mexican wrestlers feel no pain.
I think it's the mask.
I think it's the fact that they train on concrete.
Whoa.
Look at the arm drag.
Wow.
What a beautiful
I cannot believe he just took a guy that
side.
Is that possible? Apparently so.
Man, I'm telling you, they are Lucha Libre wrestlers are billed as superheroes, and Lucha Star is showing why tonight. Up against the ropes, a double lockdown. Triple shot, Fox. Oh, up the side of the head.
He's up to the cover right now.
One.
I tell you what, these little guys, they got a lot of energy in them today. It looks like they're catching Mosh Pit Mike out of control here.
What are they going to do here?
Big forearm. Another big forearm. Lucha Star dropping forearm from the side of the face. Is he going to attempt to throw Mosh Pit Mike?
Oh, of course, right here.
That's so hard.
He's going to charge at him. It's a miss.
Oh. Going to roll on the side. Oh. Right in the side. I think Mosh Pit Mike's out. He's out. His eyes were on the back of his head.
Here we go. Not very good ring positioning there by Luchasaur. Not as far, of course.
Way too far away from his own corner.
Oh, it's a straight. Was that a nut shot right in front of the ref?
I don't know. I think he might have caught him in the lower part of the abdomen. That's why the referee's not calling it.
The lower part of the abdomen is in the,
groin area.
Where the family jewels are, then I guess so.
All right, looks like Sheiky's going to have to have a talk
about it. Here we go, Cedric the Hitman wearing the sunglasses in the ring again.
You know, how disrespectful.
No joke, to your opponents and to wrestling in general. If I was in that ring right now, I would slap the snot out of him. I'm telling you right now.
You know, we could call Al a big cat and somebody sock him in the eye, and then the sunglasses get engraved into his eyeball.
Oh, man, so dangerous.
And over goes Lucha Star.
The crowd's going crazy.
Oh, they're off. Here we go.
One, two.
Oh. Kicks out.
Such a close one, ladies and gentlemen. That was quarter.
Mike, get out of the ring. Come on, Mike.
I tell you what, guys.
Let him see the tag. Let him see the tag come in. He's going to let it go.
He's going to get
down from the top. Nice. Fox and Lucha Star.
What a bunch of covers. Big maneuver. You can knock him. That's a mistake right there.
Man,
that is a classic mistake. Needs to go for the pin.
Nothing but action in this first bout.
I hate to say it, but Shadow Fox is showing exactly how pretty he is by not going for a cover.
Great point, Patrick.
He goes up. We're going
to see him.
And a nice monkey flip.
Go for the cover. Get him down.
When was the last time you've seen a monkey flip, LT?
1985, Roddy Piper versus Tito Santana.
And I'll tell you what, folks, this truly does show.
No way, he just knocked him down with the clothes. I've seen it all.
This shows the inexperience from Shadow not taking the cover.
But sir, get right in the ring.
Yeah, he's not stopping. I've got control of this match.
And the ref didn't see the tag. He needs to get him out of that ring. But the Lucha
What is going on here?
Throw that DQ right now.
All right.
The referee needs to show his assertiveness. He needs to put these guys in their place.
Relic's still yet to make his way in the ring in this match, too. See what he's going to do.
Kick in the gut. Put him right down.
And show no ill effects from all that offense thrown on him by the Lucha Stars.
Oh, here comes the third ball. Outstanding by Shadow Fox.
Missed it.
He totally missed it. And he's paying for it.
And you know, that's the inexperience once again, folks.
Yeah.
Coming in on Shadow. It's a Shadow Fox.
One maneuver too many right
exactly.
there.
Exactly.
No tag.
No tag.
And the ref didn't see it be distracted. Fisherman suplex. Up and down. Ray Bissar, I'll tell you what, a lot of people don't give Bissar
up for the cover.
And he kicks out by Shadow Fox.
It's not enough offense yet. Not enough yet to kick out in the ass.
We've seen Shadow Fox in matches with the likes of guys like Rex Reed, where we are at a venue and Shadow Fox smacked his head on a light and kept coming. Shadow Fox is one of those guys. He's small, but man, he's got so much heart.
Fight. Oh, this is a big Oh my gosh, he went through the ring on that.
His back has to be broken in half.
That's almost 600 pounds on a suplex smashed through that canvas. Cover instead, he puts him in a rear chin lock.
He's taunting Lucha, and Lucha can't get in the ring here. Oh, another sneak tag.
Cedric the Hitman locking him in another rear chin lock. Actually, that's a headlock.
Referee doesn't see the tag again. Doesn't seem to have a problem with when they get in the ring.
Is that a rear chin or is that a headlock? What would you have to consider a possible chin?
He's got it. If he cinches in, which he just did, he's now have a rear chin lock.
That's what I thought.
Right. Side.
But if his arm goes under that neck, then that's a choke.
He's got to tighten that back up.
Yes.
Cedric's got to tighten that back up if he wants to take control. He's not, because he just got elbowed.
Oh, man. Oh, right to the midsection.
It looked a little low.
Yes.
it looked a little low. I'm going to question that again. We've seen a couple low blows so far in this match.
And I mean, you know, with little guys like Cedric in there, needing a back to head, that doesn't seem like anything out of his repertoire.
Have you guys ever talked to Basuri?
I have. He's actually, he owns his own trash company. The guy, he does. He owns his own trash compact company. The sound.
Oh, God, a stomp from hell.
I like a guy who owns his own.
Oh, God, a senton on the lower back. Go for the cover. There it is.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, people don't get the same. Sam's not a new professional wrestling, but people don't give him enough credit. He is one of the best rookies I've seen in quite a long time.
One thing he does better than any new guy or any older guy you see, brother. You ever talk to that guy? He's a politician, brother. He goes around to every person, politicking his way everywhere.
He wants to be EXW Wrestler of the Year. He's crushing.
Yeah, he has to play both sides of the
fence. Ladies and gentlemen, Sargon or Shadow Fox may be dead.
Oh my God.
Dear God,
with a slash like that on his back,
it's over. His back is over. He's got his finger down.
Broke up the cap.
Lucha Star with a kick to the back of his head.
And if you look to the side, Relic sitting and waiting.
The referee has his hands on
his experience. He's showing his experience because right there he had a cover and the referee didn't even make a count.
He just got away on that. That's a very inexperienced from a ref.
Oh, wow. Another power slam.
What a DDT that was. Oh, my God.
Here we go.
Shadow Fox. Look what he just pulled off. But can he make the tag?
It's about to get hot here if he makes the tag. That's if he has enough left in him after getting a beating for the last 5 minutes.
Basuda is climbing his way over. Can he get over there?
If he does, brother,
make that tag.
I don't know if he has enough left in him.
Lucha Star,
this is going to get ugly in a second, brother.
Lucha Star locks in there pretty bad. Really doesn't look like any big
hurt. Here we go!
Brother, he is the street sweeper and a broom and a dustpan.
Friday night, folks. I'm excited to be here.
I tell you what, if you didn't come here and come to this Magic Paper ticket and get this race, you're missing out big time.
Absolutely.
Because there's at least, boy, that's almost a packed house right now. There's still probably time to come down here and get a ticket if you wanted to. But if you didn't get here ahead of time to get every single match, you're missing out big time.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. This is outstanding. This entire
we got
erupted right after Relic. It's just decimating everybody. We got an EXW chant out there. We got carnage all over the ring. Bodies are falling apart. Guys can barely. I can't believe Cedric is even walking.
We have three guys laid out right now.
I mean, what do you say?
Hey, usual day at the office, huh, Sheep?
Business like always. He got a suitcase and he's heading on his way back. What is in that suitcase is what Sheiky wants to know.
You know what? It's your job to find out.
And you know, I think by the end of this night, I will find out what's in there. Maybe he has the money he owes me, huh?
Yeah, I just heard Relic wanted to talk to you, Sheiky. I don't know. So somebody just tapped me on the shoulder. Yeah. You know, I'm a broadcast journalist, so I just heard that. I just heard he wants to talk to you.
Yeah, we just relay messages, bro.
I gotta go wash my hair. I'll be back.
I'll be back. You don't have hair. That's okay.
I cannot believe that Lucha Reigns and Kyle Hawk are walking out of here. I can't believe it. After what just happened to them, I'm amazed.
Oh, man. Outstanding. Hey, let's take time to thank our sponsors real quick. We have Golden Kid. We have Max Muscle. 93.3. KDKP has been plugging us the entire time. And not to mention, Abby Tattoo Parlor on 12th Street in Highland.
Awesome.
And I also want to say, Memorial Day weekend, I want to thank all of our veterans, of course, for making this country safe and all those people who've lost their lives for making sure that I get to live the life the way that I do. I just want to say thank you.
And God bless all of you people.
Absolutely. I want to say hello to Echo Company, 2nd Battalion, 5th Marines, of you and I was with, guys, making home safe.
I just want to say thank you to Ryan Castellucci also. By the way, if anybody didn't know, this man's a former Marine.
I was in the Marine Corps.
In the Marine Corps. That's right. How many years?
5 years.
Served his country for 5 long years. I want to say thank you and shake your hand, my man.
Outstanding.
He is an in shape individual, this kid. Who's this? Oh, buddy. Wait a second. Is this who I think it is?
Boy, Mike DeLight just came out and it looked like he was flipping a bird towards the audience there.
You know what? He's a cocky. I tell you what, I know this about Mike DeLight. I've been in the ring with him. He is a cocky individual, but he almost deserves to be. He is that good.
And you know what, Castellucci? I want to say this too, man. I don't know about you guys, but usually I haven't been too fond. He's just like another people. Ever since Tatanka, Wahoo McDaniel, an Indian wrestler hasn't been very popular because nobody watches Cowboys and Indians anymore. But the Bird of Prey himself actually has me excited.
Absolutely.
It's a different kind of Indian wrestler, okay? The gimmick itself, you can say, you can make fun of it, you can say it died. But this kid's actually bringing it back by himself because he's the only Indian wrestler I know of that's worked anything nowadays.
And not just that, he's the only Indian wrestler I know that could do a dive through the rope throw on a drop kick, probably.
That's right, exactly.
I know a few Indian wrestlers, I think you do too, Lawrence.
He's a new age Indian, my friend. He's a new age Indian.
Absolutely. And gentlemen, the correct term is Native American. As he would like to.
I'm sorry. Just she cannot be called the red man.
Oh, man. Always good talk. Oh, nice job.
Yes, this is definitely not your typical beer-drinking reservation guy, yeah, you know?
You know, serving beer that we know around here.
You know, the guys you see at the Metallica concerts, you know what I'm saying?
Kyle Hawk with the Bird of Prey is getting, he hasn't been in the ring very long, but he's gaining notoriety throughout the United States. You should be seeing him, you'll be seeing a lot more of him in EXW. We've talked in the back before the show, and he's really excited, and he's on the hunt for that Elite Division title.
You think Kyle Hawk's going to try the new tattoo parlor? I mean, he looks like he can use a little bit more work on the chest and back.
He's actually, he is, we talked, he's looking to get more.
It looks like the first thing the ref actually saw so far tonight, huh?
Michael Wright right now is claiming that he got the tights pulled. Is that even possible on an arm drag?
No, no, it's physically impossible.
That's like a bald guy claiming that he got his hair pulled, brother. That ain't that.
We're going to see the court cut. We might see.
Whoa, look at that.
The dragon screw! Dragon screw left!
Executed. Beautifully executed.
Kyle Hawk working on that ankle right now. Mike the Light stretching out the hamstring.
Oh, he's got it deeply applied too, brother. Deeply applied.
What a move. When was the last time you've seen a submission hold?
I see his cruiserweight. But the problem is his ring positioning is way too close to Rose. He has Mike the Light to go ahead and grab because he's not, doesn't have the proper ring positioning.
And then again, folks, comes with inexperience that he'll gain over the years of wrestling.
That's correct. Good call, Rose. Good call. That's right.
Yo, Mike DeLight currently out of Las Vegas being trained by the likes of Disco Inferno, Sid Bodie, and a host of others that live out in Las Vegas. And, man, it really makes for such a great wrestler. And I almost want to say,
Oh, big shot to the referee.
And, you know, I've seen a lot of great guys coming out of Las Vegas as of lately.
It's definitely a hotbed.
The Southwest has been a hotbed for wrestling lately.
And you know what? They're all coming here. They're all coming to you, Sheiky.
Because why not? This is the greatest place to work, I mean, of all time. As you can see, look at the matches we've already had tonight.
We've had Morelic decimate somebody, and now you have the two best cruiserweights possibly in the Southwest.
They had really decimated the whole ring besides the referee. I thought he was going to
get back. That back elbow is one of the biggest back elbows I've seen in a long time, man.
Slow count by the ref. Got him in a rear chin lock. Stretching on him.
That's the second time tonight we've seen that rear chin lock. Apparently a lot of wrestlers like that hold, huh?
Tell you what, he's digging that knee. Now, what we didn't see before the first match, Mike the Light digging that knee into the top portion of the upper back right there.
See, fish hooking him.
Now, Cassidy,
think he's fish hooking him.
For all the fans that may not be familiar with this, they might look at this new fans, or even fans that think they know it all, and they might say, why even apply that hold when everybody knows the guy's not going to give up? The reason why, just in case the person might say something like that with a smart attitude, is because you got to wear down your opponent to have any chance to either pin him or submit him. So you may not get him to tap or submit to that, but that'll definitely wear him down for later parts of the match where you may get to pin him.
Well, if you know anything about physiology, what that move does, you're causing knots to form to the upper part of the back, into the shoulder blades, into the muscles right there. And what happens is when you have knots form that area of your body, it's cutting off circulation to the rest of your body.
Kyle Hawk,
your air forward to the rest of the lungs.
And if air can't get to the rest of the lungs, what would that mean, Cash?
That means you're going to die real early in that match. And if you can't perform at your peak, especially here at EXW,
you don't need to be in that ring, that's for sure.
And Mike the Light is taking it to Kyle Hawk right now. Kyle Hawk is just, he's almost getting beat out of his boots right now.
Mike the Light looks good. It's good to see him back in such good shape.
Sunset flip. Kyle was tripping up.
Both guys drew.
What a boot to the face of Kyle Hawk.
No, this is a heck of a match so far.
Absolutely.
This is a heck of a match so far.
Mike the Light showing why he truly comes to Arizona and why he belongs here in the NFL.
Making a huge name for himself in EXW, and what a place to do it, like tonight on Extreme Measures. He wins his match tonight, that's definitely going to put him in the ranks.
Absolutely. You're going to see both of these guys in the running for the Elite Division title, and I would put my money on either one of these guys to win that title very soon. And you know what happens then.
Standing vertical. You don't see that move very often. Usually it's a snap suplex or a quick fisherman. Looking to put out the pressure off his back like right now, because that maneuver holds him up in the air to where blood flows from the skull, and then whammo,
man,
you take out the legs real fast.
One eye's in a lot of pain right now. He looks like his, it looks like his upper portion of his shoulders is cramped up.
Oh, he's going to put him up on the top rope this time?
Oh,
we might be seeing a superplex.
Oh, man, draped him right across. Right across the family jewels.
Oh, Lord. I was going to say, hurt somebody's marbles.
Oh, man, we're going big here, guys. We are going big.
The hottest for him tonight.
Oh, shot, one shot. Another one by Kyle Huff. Man,
off the road.
Still had a little bit left in the mountain. Still had a little bit left.
Oh, Lord.
What a kick to the face. Oh, my God.
What a
that was
shot.
Amazing. That's a jump.
That's got to be it.
Football punt. Two.
He cannot kick.
Oh, he kicks out.
I can't believe he kicked out of that.
Oh, I cannot believe the action we have seen in two matches.
That was amazing.
First two matches of the card. I can't sweep his cheek. I've never seen what I just saw before.
That's why they wrestled for EXW.
Absolutely. Did you see the snap on his head after he got kicked in the face?
Wow.
How is he awake right now?
Wow. He's barely. He's trying to shake off the cobwebs. Up in the rope.
Spinning in front of him. What was that?
I have no idea.
Spinning rock bottom.
Wow.
Absolutely. Both men are down. Ref starts to count.
Man, I'll tell you what. If you've ever watched Extreme Championship Wrestling, take a good hard look at the two men in the ring right now. And that's what EXW is
all about, man. That is raw wrestling at its finest.
I'll tell you what. If you don't like what you're watching on TV right now, if you don't like what you're seeing on your TV screen,
you don't know wrestling.
Yeah, absolutely.
What a top shot. Two and one.
Kyle Hawk is cleaning house, folks.
Oh, the light bailing out.
I'm out of this. She says he's got a
break. I smell a dive coming, ref. You better get out the way, ref.
Get out of the way, ref.
The ref.
Ref, get out of the way.
He's going to get attacked.
Ref, you better move.
You better
move. Ref, you better move.
Oh, he's going to take this.
Oh, oh my God.
Chanting, folks, what a dive outside of the ring.
Oh my God,
pandemonium in the ring, huh?
He's got him walking, he's got to finish him off right now, Cashman.
He's got to
finish him off.
Man, pop to the guys, he's got the chop going. Kyle Hawk is looking
at him. Here we go, he's going off, springboard up. No! That's got to be it, he's got to finish him.
Go for the pin, here he goes.
Here we go.
One, two.
Kicked out of that. Do you believe that, Cashman?
He's got to finish him off, guys.
That must have been.
Is this really only the second
out.
Man
oh
right
my
now?
God. Oh my God. Absolutely. I'm telling you what, the better play.
Here we go.
Oh, what a kick.
Thunderous kick to the crowd.
Oh, one more.
Those tie kicks are. Spinning Ichigari in front of the face.
That was beautiful. The crowd's going crazy, folks.
He's gone. He could be hitting with the dream catcher right now.
He's caught.
Oh, Hawk's finishing him over.
Here he is.
On the dream catcher. Here he goes. It's up. Oh,
Mike Light says, not today.
Mike Light up against the ropes.
Let's see.
Code break.
Ace Buster. My gosh.
He's over the counter. That's got to be it. That's it.
Two.
Go.
He kicked out with every last ounce of breath.
What is it going to take to finish off either one of these two guys?
This is amazing.
You know, you got the death-defying, high-flying, bird of prey, Kyle Hawk, giving it all he's got tonight. These guys know this is our show of shows today in Phoenix, Arizona. And Kyle Hawk trying to fight back.
Shot him up.
Small
headbuster.
And how about the great shake that Mike DeLight came back to EXW in? I mean,
absolutely.
This guy is just short.
He's pulling down his knee pad. He's exposing the knee.
See, and
there's a problem here, though. This could backfire. High risk. We were talking about this the other day, Castellucci. High risk, high reward.
Yes.
But if he doesn't hit, could be the end of his match.
Absolutely.
Going for that knee. Oh. And there you go. That's the finishing call. The dream catcher. It's called the dream catcher. Oh, what a kick in the gut. Here it is. The gut.
Here it is.
Two, three,
it's over.
Wow,
Kyle Hawk is
your winner. I don't even, I tell you what, though, Mike the Right was every bit as good right there. One maneuver.
That's all it takes. One maneuver is the difference between Mike the Right and Kyle Walsh winning that match.
Absolutely. I'll tell you something who just climbed the ladder tonight, guys. Kyle Hawk definitely deserves a little more opportunity.
He was one maneuver better tonight. That's it. One maneuver better is all that separated those two.
Absolutely. Back and forth. It's an exciting match. There's got to be an Elite Division title championship match soon in Kyle Hawk's future.
And you know, like I just said, that man definitely put him in the rankings for it. He's definitely on the ladder on his way to that Elite Division championship.
We return the stage to two men that have been clawing their way to the top of the XW for a long time. The following competition will be a singles competition and will be for a number one contender spot for the EXW World Heavyweight Championship.
And this is the match that I made for
Andrew Henry's favorite, sir.
What do you guys got your money on tonight? We gotta go with the, we gotta predict winners tonight.
I'm going with Andrew Henry.
We're going Vegas style. We're going Vegas style. We gotta make some bets. Hold on. And the exotic Adrian Street from 1979. Who gives a
no homo on that?
No homo on that. I don't think there's any homo in this
guy. No. I tell you what,
wow! And then that's why we're EXW, man. That's why we're EXW. Woo!
Well, I'll take the determination, guys.
But you know what? Even the loser at some point is pretty much going to have a shot because he's second in line. So, if let's say Cutler Wright wins, if he doesn't win, he has number one shot. Oh, when he gets a heavyweight title shot.
Oh, the two bulls! The two bulls are going at it!
Ah, they're going to lock up, folks. These two dudes look like.
And that means Andrew Helms will get the title shot later anyway. So,
I'll tell you what, if you want it first, Castanucci.
If you are a true wrestling fan, I want you to think right now, Randy Savage against Chris Benoit.
Now, Cutler Wright, though, is losing out right now because he does not have his left arm hooked around the head. No, Andrew Helms. You lose power and you lose a lot of leverage by not having it.
Absolutely.
You know, Andrew Helms has on his side, even though he's shorter, people would say that's a leverage advantage to Cutler Wright. Andrew Helms has one center of gravity
Absolutely. On
his side when it comes to a lockup like that.
He's almost like a little pit bull, you know what I'm saying?
You know what, dude?
It's like a pit bull dog, you know, his center low to the ground, it can just pull you around the place. That's the way that Andrew Helms is. He's like a pit bull.
Now, if you didn't know about Cutler Wright was trained to be a shoot fighter before a professional wrestler. So you're going to see a lot of shoot fighting moves. You're going to see a lot of moves you'd see in a bar if you guys were in a fight.
Really?
Here we go, Cutler Wright with the roll-up.
What you're going to see is a classic wrestling match.
Absolutely.
Because both these men are fine technicians in that ring. Don't kid yourself. Andrew Helms may look like a little pit bull, but Brian, he's a technician in every sense of the word.
Stuck in a close line, going for the other. Here we go. One, two.
Three near pinfalls right away. Cutler Wright wants to end this thing fast and just get this match over the end.
My God.
He wants his championship match, and he wants it fast, folks.
Shinky, what do you think? Who's looking better right now? Even though there was an arm drag, who's looking better out of the two of that exchange?
That's hard to say. You know, Cody Wright's on top right now. You know, that's the place you want to be in a wrestling match. It's definitely on top.
Now, Shiki, I want to ask you the question. If these two weren't wrestling each other, if one of them wasn't in the company and the other one was, who would you have picked to have the number one contendership?
You know, that's a hard one to say with all the competitors out there and everybody poking a Harmon at me these days. It's hard to say.
Oh, I went for a takedown by Ace.
I've been actually studying these two for some time now, and it was just having to work out right that they were about to rip each other's head off, that I can make a number one contenders match like this. It just worked out perfect for tonight.
Oh, wow. Shoot! Body slam by Andrew Helm with the cover.
For the cover. The rebel without a cause. Your third man in the ring pops the referee.
Do we have a Ballard here? Oh, that's Pop. Oh,
Pop Ballard.
I don't know. I thought Shane or somebody.
He asked me to stop calling him that.
Andrew Helman went to the well three consecutive times with an elbow. Missed all three times.
Man, he's trying to nail it. Andrew Helman, look at his tricep.
Brother,
you can see his tricep from here.
Now, that's where Andrew Helman will backfire on occasion. The guy literally eats Constantine wire and pisses napalm. He's 100 miles an hour all the time. So the problem is that sometimes they just keep going to that well when he's shooting. And that's what just happened.
And another thing with these two folks, they both think they got screwed out of their title matches. So both these guys think that they have the right to their belts. So both of them just want to be in and out of here as quick as possible and get that match with a champion. You know, they both have been claiming to be screwed for the last few weeks now, which is why I had to make this match.
You know, it's definitely something that has to be earned.
Ooh,
oh, man, what a form! In fact, I think he missed the form and caught him with a floating elbow.
Wow.
It almost
yeah,
looks
like you spit out blood.
Oh, God!
Helmet has those elbows that'll just slap his face right off.
Andrew Helmet just absolutely took every part of his body and threw Cutler right into that ring post. Wow, I mean, seriously, 55 miles an hour.
220 pounds tossing you face first, almost face first. You know, you can get it around in time.
You know, guys, smash into that recording.
Wow. I used to wrestle myself, and I don't miss that at all. I really don't. People slamming me around. I don't miss that at all. I really don't.
You know, I don't miss it, but it is what it is. It's what makes it exciting.
Oh, I agree with that.
Rashid, right now, you have been locking in a camel punch, my friend.
I would be definitely working my way to it, that's for sure.
And he's using your technique, Shiki. Andrew Helmut the back. Working on that lower back.
He needs to lock something in right now, and he needs to work that back. There's too much time. He's going to allow time to recover. And if Cutler recovers, all he needs is, like we talked about, one maneuver will take home the match.
Oh, again, to that lower back. Jeez.
He's dropping those vicious elbows. Those are the pins.
I'll tell you what, I speak from experience. Both of these men know how to dissect you. They know how to pick apart a body part and take you apart piece by piece.
He needs to wear him down right now. We need to see a hole in the real shoe. He needs to wear this man down. If he keeps picking him up and allowing him to get up, that won't happen. You see what I'm talking about?
Absolutely.
Whoa! That's why we needed to put him in a hold. Now we allowed him to get momentum back in his favor.
That's
man,
what happened.
Cutler Wright going for a cover. Two.
Oh, wow. That's him. And right now, Cutler Wright has to be putting him in a hold. He's allowing him time to recover. That's not a good thing, Cassidy.
No, not at all.
George Irvin's in place.
Beautiful executed German that way.
Well, the cover here, he may have it. He's
gonna go for the
pin. Here it goes. One,
two.
Yeah. Oh, there.
Wow.
Two and three. Did he kick out?
He kicked out. He was like an inch off the mat.
Referee Potts Ballard checking right there.
I'll tell you what a frustrating feeling that could be. When you think you have the match won and you think you're good in that three count, he kicks out. What a frustrating feeling. What a knee to the face. My God.
You know, and here is where we were talking about earlier. What's going to give up?
Was Helmut going up top?
I believe I put my money on Helmut giving out first and just start resorting to dirty tactics. Because
it's a matter of time, I agree.
If you recall, Cutler Wright beat Andrew Helman in the Elite Division title specifically because Helman threw everything he had in him. And Cutler Wright would not die. There's no quitting. In fact, the next couple of weeks, Cutler Wright spent nursing every single one of his injuries. He didn't go to the gym. He didn't do anything. He sat home. His girl took care of him. And that was it. He sat his ass on the couch. And now they're back in the same match for a bigger prize.
As I'm talking to I've been talking to Helmut a lot lately, you know, kind of getting ready for this event. And he's been doing a lot of training. He's been doing in the gym a lot lately.
He looks a lot bigger.
He looks like he's crisp right now. Because he realizes that this match right here can make or break his career. It's an important match for him tonight.
Absolutely. Yeah. Oh, man. It's almost, it's
how the right's kind of locked in.
Sleeper hold?
Is that, it looks like
he's got him a sleeper. He unhooked the arm, he went right to the neck. He's got him a sleeper.
Bob Valley's
going home here. This might be it, guys. This may be it.
Oh, what's this?
If Hellman can reach behind, if he can get, it looks like he can't get that hand behind Cutler Wright's head. If he can get his right hand behind Cutler Wright's head, he will have him in a rear naked choke.
One more drop, folks, to Cutler Wright's head. No. Cutler Wright's fighting up. He said, no way. That's how close it was.
Trying to mount a comeback here against Andrew Hellman.
There we go. Momentum starting. Eric breaks
the
leg.
There we go.
He's got momentum coming up. Work his way up now. He's worked his way up.
Hellman's got that whole right, lock
in
really.
He's getting the adrenaline going. He's getting the blood
flowing.
Here he goes. Oh, back down.
What a smart maneuver by Andrew Hellman.
I think I see some hair pulling, but I don't think the refs see it.
You know what? It doesn't matter. He did what he had to do at that point. In that situation,
LT,
it doesn't matter.
I disagree with you. It does matter. Andrew Hellman doesn't need to lose cool in his match. He needs to keep his head, not do things like pull hair, because he's a talented wrestler.
You and I agree most of the time, but here we go. We're going to have to disagree, and I'll tell you why. Let me ask you a question. If you had to pull hair to get a world title shot or become the heavyweight champion, would you do it?
You know what? That's a tough question.
Would you do it? Yes or no?
No.
You're a liar.
Stop me. I just don't pull hair.
You got to win the title and become the world heavyweight champion. You wouldn't pull hair one time.
You know,
one
time. That's your tactics. That's your
I would. You got to do it sometime.
I would agree with LT on this one, because you do what you got to do to put yourself in the best position.
It's only cheap if you get caught.
Absolutely. And if the ref doesn't see it, you got nothing to worry about. That's the way Sheiky plays.
Oh, my. Wow, what a lariat. Oh, what a lariat.
Oh, my God.
And a back elbow. And another spinning back elbow.
Momentum's picking up. Momentum is picking up.
Oh, the crowd goes nuts.
Boy, he's throwing sevens right now, brother. He is throwing sevens.
Here it comes. We can see a roll of dice right now.
Oh, European up.
No man knocked his head right
out on his feet.
Up against the ropes. Oh, the drop kick. And he held.
Look at that, man. Again, showing the brains right there. You know what? He got his snot knocked out of him. But he had enough left in him to think things up. Hold on to the ropes with everything you got left.
Absolutely.
I'll tell you what, that's why Andrew Hellman doesn't need to resort to dirty tactics, because he is that intelligent. He is that good of a wrestler. He's one of the most technically sound wrestlers I've seen in quite a long time.
I agree, but you got this. What? Up and over. Oh, no.
Oh, my God. What was that? That was amazing.
That's it.
That's got to be it.
Oh, wow. He's getting out a lot of time, though. He's got to get him over here.
He's got to go for the cover.
Way too much time. He's got to go for the top.
You need to fight if you want that pin. What are you getting out for?
What is he doing? Go for that pin.
Right, what's to finish him off?
That's inexperience.
He's going up.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely. I have to agree with that. I would have left for a recap. Cutler Wright wants to add.
High risk, high reward. High risk, high reward.
I see the spinning.
So the problem is,
this better pay off.
He took a long time getting up. Hellman rolls out of the way. Cutler Wright barely gets up to his feet. Hellman gets up to his feet. What's
that? There it is! The whiplash! Oh, damn it! The whiplash! That's the whiplash!
He didn't go for the cover!
Hellman's apologies! Hellman, he got hurt, and I understand a little what the heck he's thinking.
Both men are hurt. These guys
are. I know he's got a lot taken out of him, but this is it! This is for the marbles!
Hellman goes down.
Here it is!
Cover right here!
Come on!
Just get the arm over.
Come on! Hellman, reach your hand over!
I guess
we got it. There we go.
Right now.
Here we go.
Hook that leg.
One,
go.
Two, three. And that's it.
Wow. Like I said, huh? Right now.
Andrew Hellman, the number one contender for the EXW Heavyweight Championship, please.
Wow.
Trevor Wright. You will see Willie Mack. And you will see guys like Kyle Hawk, Val Venus, Derek Nightmare. And you will truly know what EXW, Elite Street Wrestling, is all about. And we will change you. We will change your mind on what professional wrestling is.
There's your number one contender for the heavyweight champion, folks. Andrew Hellman, the Rebel with a Claw. And what a match that was, huh?
Yeah, just for fans that don't know, who is the Elite Television Champion?
The Elite Division Championship is vacant right now.
It is.
The Elite Division Championship is vacant right now.
For all fans that don't know.
Yes, sir,
I believe we have a match tonight to fill the Elite Division Championship. I believe it's Willie Mack against Rex Reed.
How about that? Well, new number one contender, Andrew Hellman.
I'll tell you what, guys. What an exciting night this has been so far.
And now, folks, well, first off, is everybody having a good time so far?
Wow, how do you not?
Why?
Wow, how do you not?
This is hot, Dad.
I mean, I'm in shape right now, brother. Listen to that roar of the crowd.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to move on to something now that has been building for quite some time.
This is going to be an awesome match, guys. This one is the reason why everybody's here.
Introducing first.
My proctor, Steven, has a big mouth.
I can't wait to hear that GFY shit, brother.
Oh, man. Woodrow's music, your former tag team partner, as a matter of fact. And Steve Ball, Steve Austin, that's it.
There's my prop there, guys. I'm going to make him a star tonight.
I would like to personally.
I can't believe you hired this guy.
He's a smart kid. I didn't know he wanted to be a wrestler.
Extreme measures.
Mike, by far and away, the most hated man in the entire company is right there talking on the mic, guys. Steve Osborne. I'm sorry.
Man, I'm calling balls. That's Steve Balls right there.
He is Steve Balls, that's for sure. Right now, the fans are chanting balls for all of you that can't hear.
You know that's funny, guys? Anytime I call this guy on the phone, I call him Balls anyway. Before they even call him, look, I just be like, hey, Balls, what you doing? And he answers to me every time.
He's not going to say that to you.
Just you know the name. I call him Proctor and Balls.
Cheer
what's that? He got five people clapping for him?
Let's give it up for him one more time.
You guys, this guy really thinks he runs my company.
Who put this all together? EXW General Manager, me!
Good try there, Steve Ball.
I almost want to put it out to the ring myself and smack this kid in the face.
Hey, can he fire me?
No, I can fire anybody.
Not you. Can he fire me for calling Steve Ball?
No, he cannot. But
you guys, tonight, for the regular crowd, left
in
the
face,
they're kind of idiots.
Whoa. I told him, Steve, when I had to take a vacation, run the show once and twice. This guy blows things out of proportion. Look at the cute knee pads he wore to the ring.
Are they volleyball knee pads?
I think they're the size of my wrist. And those little gloves? Crowd calling for it. GFY.
For anybody who's ever seen that maneuver, it is devastating.
Yes.
Tyson Tyler, get him in the ring, man. It's all over.
Brother. Wow.
We might need to call an ambulance right now.
Let me explain to you people.
So after a second,
he's still talking.
Looks a little furious right now.
Here they come, the
Maybe
network.
Maybe it's a haircut.
The network, Johnny Stanfoli and Tyson Tyler. I'll tell you what, if you're watching this at home and you've never seen the GFY, let me quickly explain to you.
Ladies and gentlemen,
GFY, hold on a second.
Their way to the ring, the team of the one, the only Tyson Tyler, Johnny the Bull Stanfoli.
To that crowd go wild, huh? The network is a love team here.
The GFI is basically a code breaker into a German suplex. I've never seen anything like it before.
I tell you, that's one of the most devastating moves in professional wrestling today, by far. GFI,
devastating move.
You know, devastating maneuver by a devastating tag. Ever since that move debuted in ESW, I've been getting phone call after phone call after phone call telling me to outlaw this move, ban this move, that I'm going to get sued, this and that, and nobody wants to take this move. That's how devastating this thing is. That's confidence right there, folks.
Johnny the Bull Stanfoli, is he not in great shape?
That is confidence.
What a body on that man. Not that I'm looking or anything, but I mean, my God.
Wait, no homo?
No specimen.
No homo?
No, not at all, not at all.
That's twice in one night, LT, you're worried, alright?
Both of these two are great
athletes. I told you I wanted to touch his can, then we got something to worry about.
You know, Tyson Tyler was a former baseball player in the minor leagues.
Absolutely, absolutely. And everybody knows Johnny the Bull Stanfoli, former ECW, former WWE, former WCW.
So, you know, we got a couple of major athletes.
He crushed it. He lifted in the air 400-pound Rikishi Fatu.
Wow.
The biggest ass in the history of the WWE.
That person has a gigantic
ass. Oh my God, the worst thing I've ever seen in my life. But he lifted that man in the air, for God's sakes.
And the two big men started off tonight.
We got the two bulls going head to head right now. Who's winning this one?
I don't know. I can't really call it. I've been in the ring. I've been in the ring with Josh Gamboa.
Tie up, folks. Looks like a pretty even tie up.
Whoa.
It's broken apart. Test of strength on Woodrow.
Johnny the Bull Stanfoli is looking at himself about 10 years ago.
What is showing that
a massive, right now.
Massive chest muscle. I think he thinks it's funny.
You can't help it.
He's got a big smirk on his face.
Woody
Maybe it's a haircut.
Woody kind of looks like a large child at times. he's and they're calling him Pecker, ladies. So far we've got Balls and Pecker chant. Outstanding.
Another tie-up and break-up on that one again. Looks like Woody's getting the best of him with his crowd. The crowd's trying to get under his skin. That could be a problem for him in the match. If he lets him get to him too much, he could lose his focus on what he's got in the ring.
That's outstanding. Oh, a test of strength, really?
Wow.
I
haven't seen this since Billy Jack Haynes and Hercules Hernandez, WrestleMania 3, Pontiac Silverdome, 93,127 fans.
Wow.
We were going to see a freaking test of strength. You got to be kidding me. What does GFY stand for?
Go F yourself. It's a back east thing. It's Italian.
Gotcha.
I knew it. As soon as Johnny spit it out, I'm like, really? Did he just tell the dude to go F himself? That's where. And Woody getting worn down.
Oh, yeah.
Like Johnny the Bull. Woody coming
out. I told you Johnny the Bull was going to. I told you Woody was going to get on top of him. I told you Johnny's going to come back.
Both sides
I told
of the
you.
Fence there, Lauren.
No, no, no. That's good thinking right there. I'm not going to lie. That's good thinking right there.
Oh, he's cranking on the head. What a tight headlock.
Look at his ropes. There goes Woodrow. Oh, nobody moves on the shoulder tap.
Power versus power.
Get the ropes again. Bam.
Immovable object versus a movable object right here.
A minute later.
This is the back. Huge clothesline by Johnny the Bull Stanfoli.
Johnny the Bull cleaning house. Tyson Tyler. What was that?
Flying knee drop into his elbow.
Flying knee drop. dropkick. There's a knee dropkick.
That's what I would call it.
Right in the stomach, knocked him out of the ring.
You know, Tyson Tyler dislocated a finger or something.
Tyson Tyler is
so innovative. He's so innovative, he just makes stuff up. That's out.
Tyson Tyler with a jump kick to his arm, now he looks like he's holding
his arm. His timing was a little bit off on that one. He went knee to skirt. They are chanting for the GFY.
And they want it early, folks. So it looks like they've been hungry.
Nobody. All right, here comes Dennis Sparks.
All right,
worn
Dennis
Sparks.
Tyson Tyler.
And you guys don't think that the network there is over, do you?
No. No, just a little bit. Oh! Oh! Superman form! Oh, excuse me, back elbow.
Shades of the legendary Chico Santana.
Here comes a snap suplex. Outstanding.
Beautiful executed.
Two. Hey, that's your family right there, LT. You're a man.
That is.
Helped train this guy, and he is doing outstanding right now.
Yes, he is.
You gotta be a little proud of him, LT. You gotta be a little proud.
As long as he keeps his head in the game, I am. You know, as long as he keeps his head in the game.
As of now, he looks like his head's pretty far into the game. He's been making quite a name for himself lately.
I have never seen Tyson Tyler chop.
And he says, get back over there, I'm not done with you.
Same for the ride. Wow, Devin Sparks ate that turnbuckle.
Devin Sparks is having some back trouble now after the last couple of back shots. What's this?
Watch side rush.
Nice. Oh, nice.
Two side rushes.
Shades of the Hitman Hart. Two.
Goes for the cover. Kick out at the
Tyler. Does that better than anybody else in the XW.
Yes, he does.
I've never seen somebody, with the exception of Bret Hart, hit that side rush.
Look at those knees.
We tight knees up face. He's learning stuff from Johnny the Bullet. What's going on right there, LT?
Vicious knees.
Look at the clothesline.
Spear right to the midsection.
Dennis Sparks had to have had three ribs broken on that one.
As he goes for the cover.
That was like a missile right to his sternum.
Let me explain the situation if nobody knows at home. Devin Sparks is going for a knee, that high knee lift that he does. Tyson Tyler is trying to go for a spear at the same time. It was almost a block, and that's why both of them went down.
I have to say, folks, I think Devin Sparks got a rib broken or two.
Here we go.
What a power! Unexpected by Devin Sparks.
Yes. Devin needs to get out of there.
Woodrow Santinelli gets him in the ring. We're going double suplex right here.
And Steven looks good.
Oh,
Steven looks really happy. He better hope he doesn't get caught up in that ring with one of those, with any one of those guys.
He almost had him on that.
That was a close one.
Oh man, pound the back. I'll tell you, I've unfortunately been in the ring with Woodrow, and I know the power he possesses. Unfortunately,
he's got him right in his corner, a bad ring position by Woodrow Santinelli. I mean, he can literally tear. Are you kidding me? He's about an inch away. Lift him up and get him out of there, brother. There we go.
Smart taking on Woodrow Santinelli.
He might have hurt me right there.
Way to go, coach. Good job. Really could have changed the title of this match, LT.
The look on Stevens' face, he looks pretty confident right now that he may not have to get in there. But he got
stars
in that ring.
He's going to put him down right now with a big mover.
He caught him! Oh, man. What a backbreaker. One more, says Woodrow Santinelli. Man. Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's it right there. That's one power.
Woodrow just has him over his knee, just pressing on him. Pressing on his chin.
Look at the back on that neck.
Pressing to his back is amazing.
One, two. Oh, Tyson Tyler barely kicked
out. Really a kick out, folks. That was crazy.
Front face lock by Woodrow Santinelli. Looks like he missed a
second. Yes, he is. Jason Garrett's going to pick him over the score. Here we go.
No way.
Here we go.
Huge body slam by Steve. Really? Is this really going to happen?
All right, Steven. Now is your chance. You want to become a star.
No, he is not. You can't see me. Is he really going to do this?
I have no idea.
I think he hurt himself. He hurt his hand on the slap.
Oh, leg drop. I didn't think it really did anything. Another leg drop by Steve Osborne, and it did nothing at all. I'm pretty sure
these fans are all over him.
They are pissed. I tell you what, these are unhappy fans right now. They want to see this guy get in there and just get his head ripped off. That's what they want to see.
Wow, they were all over him, huh?
I haven't seen that deep of a boot chance.
Of course he got right out of there.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, come on.
I've seen that kind of wrestling. You go when the guy's down, you get a move or two in, and then you get the hell out of there as soon as he starts.
Now, Chief, this maneuver looks familiar. What's he doing wrong, Chief?
Well, I'll tell you what, this is a move out of my old book. But
that's
he's
what I'm
not,
saying. What's he doing wrong?
He's not sitting on his back. He doesn't have his arm cinched, and he's not the Sheik putting the camera on.
Oh, that's it.
Anybody's going to be doing that.
He's a little Sheik in that ring,
putting on that camera.
I'll tell you what, I'll set him up. Sheik will hit him right out of the
park. Oh, yeah.
That's awesome. Oh, what's like Andrew Helm using the smarts, man. You know, he pulls the hair and he's cheating. But again, the referee allows it. Why not?
And he has such a handful of hair he can grab. I mean, it's only, in my situation, I would probably go for a move like that.
I mean, we can't all be Boy Scouts like Castellucci.
Oh, he dropkicked by Woodrow Santinelli. I'm just by Tyson Tower, not doing much. Well, to Woodrow, Woodrow puts him in the rear chin lock.
Again.
Turning that
the old-fashioned neck twist.
Is that a cravat?
No, doesn't have the cravat locked in.
Yeah, in the movie No Holds Barred, Tiny Tim Lister, otherwise known as Zeus,
that was his
applied the hold, and Rick Tork hold his head right off.
Literally.
Didn't he?
Oh, man, what a punch.
Oh, he got shot.
Where's the Johnny the Bull?
Johnny the Bull is pissed off.
He wants to
be
angry now.
Oh, Lord, this could be very, very ugly.
I'll tell you what, you better hold Woody doesn't accidentally tab an old Steven.
What is Steve's balls doing?
He's so weak, he can't even pull him to the side.
He's trying to pull it.
That's
what this 6-pound man.
That's my block there, folks.
Wow. Woodrow's doing all the work on his team, by the way.
Yes, he is.
Devin's hardly been in the ring at all. Devin Sprague's hardly been in the ring.
And he does not want the clothesline by Johnny the Bull. Johnny the Bull taking Woodrow Santinelli into the corner. And from post to post, here comes Johnny the Bull's stand boy.
Crushing splash. Is he going for it again?
He's going for one more right here. Here comes Johnny the Bull right now. Oh, Woodrow got the boot up.
I knew it.
No, oh, it was a spot buster by Johnny
the Bull.
What a save.
You broke it up.
You can feel the spine buster coming because I see Johnny will pull that one out a lot.
Yeah.
He'll get a guy thinking that he's hurt, and then bam, once he comes in, wham. Oh boy, he's gonna,
what is this?
Is this the GM? Is this,
Is he setting him up? Does not see
well,
that.
Well, we know Johnny the Bull definitely does have working family jewels. Oh, steel chair in the ring.
Oh, what's going on?
Is this no holds barred?
Wait a second. Wait a minute. I believe the ref just kicked Woody out of the ring.
What?
That means this match is going to be an even match.
Are you serious? Can he do that?
Is Steven getting in that Thompson right now?
Thompson's getting him out of the ring. This match is that important.
Is Steven the legal man in the ring right now?
That's what I'm saying.
Is he going to try? Oh, my God.
Are you kidding me?
We have an even stage match. He's going down big.
He's pulling Tyson's move.
Oh, Tyson catches him on his butt.
Go for the cover. One, two. Oh, man. Johnny the Bull got out just in time.
Tyson, what did he come from? Looks like there's a little bit of confusion in the ring there.
I believe, ladies and gentlemen, that Woodrow Santinelli barred from ringside.
Wow, he got kicked out of here, man. He just got 86, brother.
Making this match
Demolition Axe Smash, ladies and gentlemen. Demolition Axe Smash.
Oh, Jesus. Tommy inside out.
That was beautiful.
Is that an elimination?
One, two, three.
That's it.
That's it.
Steve Balls is less. It's an elimination match.
Whoa. So you mean to tell me that Steve Balls has to fight the two of these guys all by himself? This is bad luck. This is
Are you
crazy.
Kidding me?
This is nuts.
Steve Balls is dead.
Yes, he has to take on Buster Tyler. If Johnny the Bull stand,
he's saying count out. What is going on here? He walked
and
out.
You don't deserve it. Sorry, but it's true.
Looks like Steven got away again, huh?
You guys are still morons.
He outsmarted him.
Out!
He outsmarted him. What? No. Are you kidding me?
Okay, wait a minute. Did we just hear this in the last song?
RoboCop!
What is RoboCop doing here? Is he gonna bring justice to our
friends? I hate RoboCop!
What is it? They're calling for it. He has nobody out there to save him. And there's not
nobody's coming to his aid. Tony the Bull just said, get the table. I'm not joking around.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. I swear to God, he just said, get the table.
We have RoboCop, and he's just watching.
If you don't know, EXW is infamous for having our own tables.
Yes, sir.
And you'll see exactly what we're talking about right now.
Tyson Kyler putting it in the ring. My God, there is nobody to save this poor kid. And I say poor kid because he's going to get his life taken from him. But I know he's a big crap talker and he pisses a lot of people off. But should we kill him? Because that's what's going to happen to him. If they get their hands on him, he's going to be killed.
You know, I almost, let me stress, almost feel bad for what's about to happen.
I made this match happen. This is my fault. I'm kind of happy. I'm not going to lie. Crazy, guys.
He's gonna die.
Are you serious? He weighs 100 pounds soaking wet. Oh! I think we're gonna need a paramedic, guys. As much as I can't stand the kid, I think he's dead. Somebody needs to go check on him.
We just had a GFY through a table. I got a feeling that's the last.
The referee, guys. What do you say? I'll bet $10 that an ambulance is coming for
him. I'm gonna put on record right now. That's the last we've seen of Steve Balls. Hey, Steve, when you get a chance to watch this at home, LT, take a good look at that camera. I hope you get better. Not anytime soon.
Hey, Corbin, I've had a big mouth, Steve, because this is what happened. And now I'm watching you in the middle of the ring dead. Thanks, buddy.
Hey,
now
Steve.
Now I really have to cover my neck.
Hey, Steve, you want to be a wrestler so bad? Let me tell you what. Guys like us right here, we trained for a long time to get in that ring. And you, by no means, deserve to be in it. And that's what happens when you step foot in our ring.
That's what happens when you're an untrained professional wrestler. A lot of people like to talk and act like they know wrestling when they've never been in a ring, never taken a bump, never felt what it's like to get slammed or punched in the mouth. Let me tell you something. Go in the ring and that's what will happen to you if you've never been trained. You can talk a big game, but when it comes to putting your money where your mouth is, you know, don't be writing checks that your ass can't cash.
Right, they gave me out of there in the crowd today. Your mom told me that that was great. I will punch them in their face.
I'll tell you what, that's what happens in elite extreme wrestling. You get lying, you get in the plate, put your ass to the table.
This is why I love this business so much that I own this company. I love EXW, and this is why I love EXW. This has been nothing but excitement and pandemonium ever since the show started today. We have Steve Balls laying dead in the ring. sorry that his teeth were
broken. I mean, I'm not going to lie, guys. I kind of feel bad for the guy.
I don't.
Usually I don't, I mean, but I mean, they really didn't have to do that.
Yes, they did.
Yeah, he did kind of have a problem.
Yeah, he had a problem. Let's
come on. What are they saying?
You know what?
And this is hilarious, brother. I mean, four matches tonight.
I'm blown up calling this match, man. Yeah. I'll tell you, I got blown up calling this match.
I mean, I'm done. I mean, does anybody have any oxygen mask? Because I'm done. The people in the front row are passing out because I'm breathing in your oxygen, brother.
Oxygen for all guys up here, okay? I tell you what.
This has been an outstanding card.
What did we get popcorn?
Look, I'll tell you right now, this is our recap of the card so far. We've just had the general manager, Steve Balls, get put to a table by Johnny Bull Stanbull and Tyson Tyler. Andrew Hellman is the new number one contender for Don the Bomb's heavyweight championship. We've had an outstanding match between Kyle Hawk and Mike the Light. Two of the greatest,
Get it out, buddy. Get it out.
I'm trying, man. I'm trying real hard. It's been one hell of a card.
Two of the best going today. No doubt about it.
And you've seen Relic decimate an entire six-man tag team matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Elite Extreme Wrestling. We know what wrestling was.
These people are chanting. Hold on. These people are chanting, drop him, man.
Well, I mean, right. That's our fans. That's our fans right there.
Are you serious?
That's our fans. That's the fans in Phoenix, Arizona.
What's wrong with
bunch of bloodthirsty animals. And I love it.
These fans are marking him for blood.
That's we need a t-shirt that says EXW, bloodthirsty animal, right there. Charles, make it happen. Make it happen, Charles.
Wow, that's all I have to say. What a nice
guy.
For the Elite Division Championship, the boy that has to go.
What?
We're in the
I love this song!
The Zombies Land USA! He is the Zombie Killer! He is Red Street!
This guy, he hates zombies, brother!
Now, I share something with him in common. We were at the Comic-Con, they had the Zombie Walk. I almost pulled my pistol. I really did. In the ring, well, I'm not going to be the nastiest wrestlers I've ever seen in EXW.
He's got a look of determination. I don't think he cares who his opponent is.
This music can only mean one man, and it's another neck attack, brother.
Well, he knows.
I've wrestled Willie Mack in the past. He was actually the third person I've ever wrestled in my life.
We are the third person to get a match on. Huh?
Yep, third person I ever wrestled. We're in for one hell of a match right now.
Yeah, this is gonna be a brawl, folks. You're going to see a wrestling, and you're going to see punching and kicking.
Anyway, you guys are talking about this, don't mind me. I'm going to be too awesome. You just got to get us some popcorn and shit.
I paid some food.
Rex Reed, man. Rex Reed looking out of that crowd.
Chicken is a soda popcorn, baby.
And all right, here it goes. Willie Mack about to lock up. That was Chizzy with the popcorn, LT. LT, you didn't get shit.
The trash talking in the ring. These two obviously locked up.
I'm shocked Rex Reed actually locked up. He got pushed. Usually a guy like that will smack you right across the face.
Willie Mack, he's a hell of a wrestler.
Seen a man the size of Willie Mack that moves like that. Look at that.
Look at that.
280 pounds.
That's amazing.
We're not talking 180 pound man. 280 pounds. Look, he moves like Bobo Brazil mixed with maybe,
I'm going to say Bam Bam Bigelow. And Rex Reed is right there.
I'd say so.
Yeah. How big, have you ever seen a big man like Rex Reed throw an enziguri at somebody, a standing enziguri? I haven't. I'll tell you what, both these men, they're like Bam Bam Bigelow's illegitimate children from different
states. What they lack in pure physique, they make up for. You would never believe how good a wrestler these two men are.
Absolutely. They get hype. They got odds better than most cruiserweights.
Yes.
It is outstanding power in both these gentlemen's
legs. I mean, look at them. You would never think they move like they do. Watch. You'll see during this match. Just watch, man. And take a look at the way Willie Mack moves. Did you see what he just did a couple of minutes ago while Rex Reed had his arm?
Yeah.
Name another man at that size that moves like that in the WWE right now.
You know what?
Rey Mysterio doesn't even move like that when he gets put in a friggin' armbar.
Yeah.
Not at all. And that was blocking a move. He started busting all this out. So, I mean, imagine what you're going to see out of his offensive standpoint.
Oh, back then. Wow, what a headlock.
Yes.
Took that headlock. Great. Headlock. Takeover's not really matters. Outstanding so far. I'll tell you, man, these guys can fly through the air, but they're also very, very pure wrestlers.
Oh, when he goes to the pin, Rex Reed goes for the pin. Willie Mack says, no way, pulls him back in the headlock.
Man, are you guys almost as worn out as I am at this point? I really want to call this match.
Bro, I told you,
these guys.
I might need to get an oxygen mask.
I tell you what, guys, this is the first time I've ever done commentary. I'm having a great time here, but wow, this is exciting. This is a whole new type of excitement for Shinky.
Oh, here we go. He's building up the momentum.
Whoa. What a suplex by Willie the Mack. My God. That was amazing.
He just threw a 300-pound man over the top of his head. He is 280, but still 300 pounds over the top of his head like nothing.
He showed out of the ring. Man, shows the strength of milk chocolate Willie Mack.
That's what I'm talking about.
Uh-oh,
he may
some
great
guys,
man.
Is he going over the top right here?
Oh, man.
No way!
Oh, you see the whip on the side of the ring? It goes farther down than what meets the eye. He actually went down another 3 feet than what we can see.
What the hell? If you're looking at something you can't see right now, the orchestra seats are down that. There's a pit down there.
Fans right now are in shock.
Yes.
They're in shock right now. Look what they just saw.
A 280-pound guy do a corkscrew flip over the top rope and land on Rex Reed.
Oh, no.
And now look at Rex Reed.
Oh! Willie Mack outsmarted him.
Willie Mack on the top.
Oh! What a kick to the face.
Absolutely. Rex Reed outsmarted Willie Mack right there.
I didn't know he could get his foot that high. That's amazing.
Oh, what a knee.
Wow.
Knee right to Willie Mack's head.
That was the red.
I would say outsmarted him, because I tell you what, they both had the same idea. I would say he outskilled him.
He was one step ahead of him.
Exactly. That was amazing.
Maybe outshaped him.
I've never seen that in WWE before. Maybe Fit Finley might have done that on occasion. He had a couple of those where you would think he was going out like that, and all of a sudden, bam. But I don't know. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Have you?
No.
And I've seen many matches, brother.
Yeah. Unless it was some hardcore, some pay-per-view.
And I'll tell you where you will see it at EliteExtremeWrestling.com. Here at EXW, you will see wrestlers like Willie Mack, like Rex Reed, permanent part of our roster.
I see drinks and popcorn coming, bro.
I see it. Right.
Do you believe our man did it? The clutch came through.
Hey, man.
That's nice clutch.
That's right. Shinky's hungry.
If you can't see this off camera, I'm not trying to ignore the match. The match is still kicking.
Oh,
now Dan drinks a cup.
Oh,
Oh my god!
By Rex Reed.
Wow, what a match.
That could be the match right now.
One,
two.
Oh, he kicks out.
That was
awesome. Look at my man Flux coming through. Also, the slowest count.
Thank you, sir.
I tell you what.
What do we owe you, my man? What do we owe you?
Come on, let's see what we got.
Hey,
oh, my God.
Is this on camera, really? All right.
Hey. Oh, Rex Reed's on the speed.
Really loves the
oh, man, he is totally taking over the castle.
Take it over there, buddy.
One, two, and oh, man, the slowest count in professional wrestling history.
And you know what, though? I think I'm going to have to talk with the referee. He seems a little inexperienced, you know? He's been kind of a little slow tonight. I'm going to have a little talk with him after the show tonight.
Oh, wow. Oh, did he just get the finger?
Oh, my God.
Did he just get the finger to the crowd?
They gave it to us.
I think he's doing it.
I now have a problem with Rex Reed.
I mean, you want a piece of me, Rex Reed? You want to... Oh, never mind. Never mind.
Yeah. Not yet. Not yet.
I'm at a box.
Two.
Is it? Willie Maxwell. Guys, I'll tell you what. Be ready for the long haul, because I'm telling you right now, these men have more than enough heart. It's going to take a lot for either one of these two guys to get put out. I've seen Rex Reed take maneuvers like you wouldn't believe and kick out. And I've seen Willie Mack take the same exact thing. I've seen him take a superplex off the top rope that I've never seen anybody take at that size before. And he kicked out. And it was a quick cut. So we're in for the long haul here, guys.
This is going to be interesting. I was in the back while these guys were changing out, and I was in Willie Mack's locker room, and he was doing box jumps that were above my chest. This guy has hops on. This is the shape of the visuals here.
Oh, what a close on. What a Larry.
Yeah, I was just going to say that, Larry. That reminds me of Shades of Jack Durango and Stan
Legendary Stan. The Texas Lariat.
There you go. There are only a few people I can see pull off like that. Rex Reed is one of them.
That's got... Whoa!
It's really good. Just
not gonna lie, I thought that could be it, but like I said, they're going to be in it for a long time.
We've seen it hook the leg. There you go, man. Merely kicked out.
One.
Double hook the legs.
Man, Willie Mack.
He's getting out.
That is a seasoned punt right there. You see what I'm saying? It didn't go for the pin once. Three times he went for the pin.
He's trying to win the match. He went for the pin. He hooked the legs just a little bit more. Seasoned punt. You know what he had to do to hook him.
No doubt about it, Sheik. No doubt about it. Willie Mack looking at the crowd right now.
He looks out.
He's trying to pump him out. You don't want to do this right now, Razor. Don't pump him. Wow, right to the throat and a chop.
That looked like a pot of nipple.
Oh, man.
Wow. That looked like he put a hole in his
head. Oh, man.
Rex Reed looked like he's firing up. He likes it.
Oh, another chop.
I think Rex Reed likes the pain. I think he likes it. There he is.
Oh, Japanese style fight right here, guys.
I'll tell you what, great wrestler, sick individual.
Oh, my God. That was amazing.
What did I tell you?
Wow. The resilience of Willie Mack.
You see how fast he came back from zero to hero, came out of nowhere, and threw a damn leg there that almost took his head right off.
I am a new fan of Willie Mack, folks. I've never seen anything like that out of a guy that size. That is amazing.
You hired him, Cheeky. Didn't know this.
He didn't see that. He didn't, that maneuver, he didn't use
it. I never seen nothing like that. I do a lot of things smart just because I do them.
Sometimes you got to do things just to do things.
Just to do them, yes. I was gimmick and all that, I see this.
Oh, my God! Woo! Oh, a back elbow by Willie Mack.
I thought you were. I'm glad I got popcorn for that.
Oh, body slam!
Willie the Mack.
Oh,
God! This match is over.
He got a belly on!
That's you!
Go! Kicks out!
Did you see that?
He kicks out!
Poked by the hair off his chinny chin chinny beard.
Amazing. Did you see that leg drop, brother? He got 6 feet in the air on that leg drop.
That was amazing.
Go Rex Reed into the corner. Here comes Willie Mack.
Let the ref go.
Oh,
what a
kick in the face.
He just ate about a size 12 leather boot right there, bro.
Whoa. Oh, what a Samoa drop. Willie hits him with a Samoa. Oh, what a hip up.
Oh, my God.
That was amazing. What a back move by Willie.
Who does that? Who does that at 280 pounds?
Anybody?
with the 280-pound man just kicked out. Oh,
again, I believe he kicked out of that. That was amazing. And that pulled off the spine muscle like that. Are you kidding me?
How at 280 pounds do you backflip like that?
That's a
I've never seen anything like that in my life.
This is a mistake. This is a mistake.
You're wasting a lot of
referee
time.
Referee going to the top like this is a mistake.
Yes. After the exchange, they just had to
shoot. Oh, mistake!
But he hit it.
I told you he hit it. I told you he hit it.
You beat Wild. Hey. Tyler, you
I'm a broadcast journalist. I have the right to make the change.
Oh, really, the Mac. Oh, my God. I cannot believe he kicked out of that. Those are some of the closest two guys I've ever seen in my life.
There's a diving headbutt off the top.
I used to be a referee, and I used to make contact with that. Those are close calls.
Rex Reed right now is asking God himself what the hell just happened. How did he kick out?
I would be asking headbutt, the referee what
300 pounds off the top rope, 12 feet in the air, into his chest, and he friggin' kicked out.
He's not
you kidding me?
That's Willie Mack for you. Willie Mack.
What is it going to take to put him down, bro?
I don't know, man. Willie Mack's 280-pound man does backflips on people.
He's rolling like that. What's this mean, guys? He's rolling his head. What does this mean? Is it close for a minute?
End of the match right here.
Willie Mack, sit down, spot button.
That's it.
One, two, three. Oh, he kicked out.
That was a kick out. That was not official. I know why. You were like the champion right there. I think the ref was handcuffed Bowen, but I want to say from our view, Willie Mack kicked out. He did kick out.
Our fans not happy with the referee.
Not at all. As the owner of the company, I'm not happy with the referee. His hand needs to be closer to iron.
You know what? I think we need a new Elite Division champion right now, but unfortunately the ref is not called.
Oh, Rex Reed! Rex Reed! Oh! Oh, God, that's it!
What?
But no cover cast illusion,
zombie. I think he needs to...
There's no cover cast illusion.
He needs to catch
it. Rex Reed needs to capitalize on that. Absolutely.
You know, we saw this earlier last night. That's where a mistake is. I know he's out of it, but you gotta get deep. You gotta dig deep. You gotta go for the pin right away.
That's what makes champions, boys. When you can come up with a move like that and capitalize on the pinball, that's what makes a champion.
Oh, Willie Mack, what a score on the road.
Man, this match is unbelievable.
That little bit of time is because he didn't get the cover.
Rex Reed wasting a tremendous amount of time in the ring. You know, pandering, not being able to get his positioning well.
And he kind of couldn't help it. Now he's wasting time. I know he was tired, but you gotta dig deep. That's what champions are made of, Sheik, like you said. You gotta dig deep when it counts.
Yes, absolutely. That's why you're in this.
Oh, man, slipping inside.
Being a professional wrestler is digging deep.
Setting Willie Mack up on the top rope.
Let's see who has what it takes to become a new champion tonight, folks.
We're gonna see something big time here, guys. I got a feeling we're gonna see something really big time here.
Rex Reed looks like he's going for the suplex. Pushed off by Willie Mack.
Wait a second.
Did you see that? It's scary, man. But, oh, my God.
These guys are pulling it all out tonight.
There's a 300-pound guy that just jump kicked over the top rope.
Told you.
Landed.
I told you. When have you seen guys this size that do this kind of stuff?
ESW, baby.
Kane's 300 pounds. You see Kane jumping in the air doing that? And I'm not dogging Kane by any means. One of the greatest wrestlers ever. But do you see him doing that? No.
I don't see him.
The Undertaker doesn't do that as good as he is.
Oh, man.
Holy Jesus, no.
No.
Willie Mack, fight him off. Dig elbows into the side of the head. Go out of line. Go out of
line. He's not taking it.
Oh, Willie Mack with a kick of his own. Sending Rex Reed to the mat. Oh, no. Oh, boy, buddy. We're going deep on this. He's going to hit.
What's he doing?
Cast the Lucha. What the hell is going to happen? We're going to see the 450. Willie Mack going for the 450.
No. He crushed him.
Number one.
Is dead. There's no way.
Yeah, that was a big...
pandemonium.
I cannot believe what I just saw.
Oh. I'll tell you what, if anybody in EXW is deserving of that title, it's Willie Mack.
Chief, you made a mess. I spilled my popcorn. Son of a gun. Good thing I didn't spill the soda, right? That would have been awesome. There he is, ladies and gentlemen.
Willie
Mack. EXW.
He deserves it.
Champion, Willie Mack. Growing up and up, he's going to win.
That man deserves it because everything he's got, brother.
Absolutely.
What a maneuver.
That was one hell of a match.
And I'll tell you what, after what Red Dream did to Mike James, that's karma right there, baby.
Absolutely. What goes around comes around. That's why.
The takeout has to start.
But I mean, the champion.
I thought
the both the guys had to step foot in the ring for that belt to win. Is this possible?
You know what? I'm not sure.
Wait a minute. Wait, who's this? Wait a minute. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, you're getting hot.
Shut your mouth.
Hey, Bill DeMont. Bill DeMont's out here, folks. And he sees that stuff.
All these people in the area have a main event tonight. I don't know what you mean to my friend Tommy Dreamer. I don't know what ticket you send him. But there's no way in hell you're not defending that championship. Do you want a main event? Yeah! Just so you don't think I'm stupid, Dom. No. I always have a backup plan.
I know all these things.
Oh,
I'm not telling
you, bastard.
Oh my God, A-Train! Oh yeah!
MGP Heavyweight Champion, the Giant Bernard!
Formerly known as A-Train, my close personal friend, the Giant Bernard, guys.
You set this up, didn't you? Oh my God!
I bet the
producer is LT! What did you tell us, man?
So I called up my close personal friend, and I let him know what was going on. And he said, "Cheat, no problem, I'll be there. I'll be glad to be there." I showed him a picture of his opponent, and he was calling after the arena. He couldn't wait to come see what he had going on.
Oh, my God. The current IWGP Heavyweight Champion.
This guy just happened to be here from Japan this weekend. He leaves back to Japan, I believe, on that stage show. So he just happened to be here.
Wow.
What a surprise.
He brought in the Heavyweight Championship.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a classically built, we've 1950 style built with a barrel chest, thin in shape arms, 6 feet 9 inches tall, 360 goddamn pounds.
The bomb don't stand a chance, LT.
I'll tell you
Seriously? I mean, wow, Chief.
I've taken a Volvo bomb, and I'll tell you, I was in the hospital for about 4 days after. And I think I was bigger than Dom the Bomb at the time. If he catches Dom the Bomb and hits him with a giant bomb, we might be taking
Chief, I'm going Dom the Bomb, 190 to 200 pounds, soaking wet with his boots on.
Absolutely.
And you got Giant Bernard at 370. You're talking twice the man.
Yep. That's amazing. And you know, the only thing that looks different to me is I think he shaved the hair on his chest.
He is bald and more tatted up.
Yeah, that's the only difference that I'm seeing right now.
Good Lord, you're right. That means he dropped at least 27 pounds.
Yes.
Let me. Oh, my God.
That means he's about 337 pounds, guys.
Let me make something perfectly clear to people who are watching this right now. IWGP Heavyweight Champion.
You know what that stands for? Do you people know what that stands for?
That means he is one of the best and most respected wrestlers in the world.
In the world.
That means that title has been held by the greatest of the friggin' greats.
Right.
Held by Antonio Inoki.
Yep.
Giant Baba.
Dom the Bomb's going for a handshake.
Are you kidding me, sir?
With your arm off, Dom. He wants to call a truce earlier. He looks scared to death, guys. And I'll tell you what, if I was in that position, Dom would be in, I would be a lot scared too.
I mean, wow.
This is amazing. There's nowhere to go. There's nowhere to go.
Dom, roll, Dom. Roll with this guy. Oh, my God. Oh, man.
He's going to chop him. My God, that's going to hurt.
Oh, no. Gabriel Gallo hitting the Giant Bernard for the back, throwing the referee, goes out of the ring, Freddie taking care of the ref, here goes, and he goes down, from behind.
guys. What, I mean,
excuse me, guys. I don't mean to be the guy screaming and yelling at her. I'm not even a commentator. I cannot believe this right now.
Well, let me tell you what. The Freak Squad, they love to use the Freebirds rule. When it comes to the tag team championship.
But right now, that's not going to matter.
This will be your main event in a six-man tag team competition. If you're going to introduce the world champion, the future champions of the world, they get a champion voice, not you, sweetheart. Step aside.
Who is this guy?
KDKB?
I don't know how you're doing.
Yeah, it's got to be 93.3 KDKB.
The future world champions, the future tag team champions. You shut up, sweetheart.
Wow. You guys call GQ Gamble a sweetheart?
Ladies and gentlemen, Phoenix, Arizona, your future champions. Your future tag team champions.
You know, this is a
Gary
short guy.
Knocker.
XW
every day.
He has to turn people away left and right.
Like I said, folks, I had a bit of a problem getting Tommy Dreamer here. I had a replacement for him in 2 seconds with this guy, with Big Bernard.
Wow. Elbow after elbow.
He's going to have a broken back right now.
Gallo just got the crap beat out of him.
And so, well, I thought I saw a camera clutch coming.
We might, in Falcon 16, we might see it for Bob right now. He's just got the neck turned.
Wait a second.
Butterfly suplex. Set him up.
Oh, look at those.
Here comes the knees to the side of the jaw right there. Val Venus, new MMA tycoon. Oh, butterfly suplex by Val Venus. Go for the cover. One, two, almost a three.
Barely gets his hand.
We almost had new tag team champions.
Oh, my God. Pandemonium. Now, how does this work, folks? If Don the Bomb gets the pin on him, does he lose his belt? Same with the champions, the tag, if they get the pin, they lose their belt.
As far as I know, it's just a tag team championship.
The heavyweight is not on the line.
Anybody, if Don gets pinned, they'll lose their belt.
Okay.
Because he's part of that team.
So Don the Bomb can lose the tag team champion for the Freak Squad. That's part of
it. Absolutely, because they're the ones that wanted to go by the Freak Squad rules. That's a good question. If they
he's the owner, how does he not know this?
Hey, you know what? That's up to him to determine. Oh, boy, you ran into that. You got stuck between a wall and a rock, boy.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh! I guarantee you he just broke his chest muscle. The muscle came ripping right off the bone. Oh, wow. Val Venus is ripping it.
Nobody makes lifting up an opponent look so hard as good as Val Venus.
Yeah. We now have four men inside the ring.
Oh, what a pit to the pit.
I don't even know who's legal at this point.
I don't think it matters. This just was pandemonium.
I think Derek Blake dropping the knee pad because he wants the other side right there. My God.
Right now, with his brother, he is getting his ass handed to him.
Absolutely. Reggie Riviera, being one of the fresher guys in the ring, needs to get in there. Whoa, what's going on? He's going under something.
Oh, we have a Frenchie's hungry chant from the crowd.
Wow.
I wouldn't doubt he was.
I mean, it's not original, but it speaks
out. Gallo into the corner. Here comes their ball. Oh, man. Beautiful maneuver by Don Bomb. That's what I'm talking about. Classic tag team move by the Freak Squad. One of the signature maneuvers. One of the best ways to kill your opponent's momentum.
That's right. When they lack in size, they make up for it. Great.
Absolutely.
You would have never seen Derek Nykerk ever do a maneuver like that. As good as he is, you would have never thought to shove his foot right in his face on the outside.
The question goes, see, Dom's logo is, I'm smarter than you. Derek's saying is, I'm better than you. Which one?
I'd rather be smart than better, because that means at the last second, my mind will outdo your
look at Dom the Bomb by Kelly taking control of Derek Nykerk. My God, this guy, what a champion, folks. What a champion.
And that's why he's the champion.
But then again, on any given day.
Oh, my God, you see Frenchie.
As big as he is, yeah. Doing that. That's amazing.
That was
awesome. Next snap. And he's going to sit out.
Oh, yeah. Derek Nykerk better watch the kneecap because they're all working on that thing.
And I'll tell you what right now, if you're watching at home and you're wondering exactly what's going on. Oh, the Giant Bernard don't even care what's going on.
Right kick to the head. GQ Gallo gets in there, starts working on the knee.
And there was no tag.
Wow.
He's sitting an ass slab on that knee right now.
Referee says Burgess let him go in. It's too hard to get him out.
Now, what's that doing? Gabriel Gallo right now, his move is stretching out the hip flexor, the lower part of the glute, and the knee in reverse. Wow. Nykerk reversed it. Outstanding. Who's smarter than who, LT?
Oh, and there we go.
Oh, GQ Gallo goes to the Gallo
and pulls him back into the middle. Folks, what a match.
GQ Gallo has been around the world wrestling, man. Never been WWE before as far as a contract, but my friend, he's been around the block.
This guy lives, eats, breathes, and sleeps professional wrestling.
Oh, my God.
I know from a friend of mine, GQ Gallo, this guy literally lives, eats, breathes, and sleeps wrestling. That's all he talks about. He lives his business.
And when you talk to Gabriel Gallo about other promotions, he'll go, WWE who?
Yes.
ESPN who? EXW.
That's what it is.
It's not, to him, it's not about a company. It's about whipping ass. That's absolutely what he does. Country to country, state to state, brother. That's all he does.
Travel, he can get his
party like a rock star.
That's right, he does. And he takes the free, rest of the free squad wherever they go. And they are currently on what's called the Scumbag Tour.
I tell you what.
Oh, what a knee by Derek Fisher.
I tell you what, Gabriel Gallo being in the freak squad makes him that much more of a bunch of freaks.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
I've seen Gallo on the road, and this guy can roll with the rest with a festival. This guy is a party animal.
Derek Nyquist
slowing down. This guy will be partying.
Derek Nyquist struggling to get to a corner, struggling to get his confidence cleared, struggling to get his wits about him. Yeah, he makes one tag. He's almost there.
His knee's
literally inches away.
Gallo's holding on to that leg, though. He's not going to let him go.
And they're going to still
he's saying, no way. Dom's got that leg. What an insecurity. Did you see that? That was amazing.
Outstanding. Outstanding. Val Venus definitely got the crowd right behind him as Derek Nyquist trying to make his way over to the corner.
Derek Nyquist showing you why he is the American athlete. This man truly is the
best. Oh, Gallo taking both sides.
Beautiful right now.
Ref can't make the cover. He's too busy with Team Elite.
Gallo kind of screwed himself there, huh?
Absolutely.
That gave Derek Nyquist just enough time to recover.
They got to work on that leg. He is hurt right now.
And Gallo has to work on it.
Gallo is bruising up the hamstring of Derek Nyquist and working on the leg and the hip flexor.
He should have
a DDT on that leg right now. No doubt.
He's got to have crab on that leg right now.
He does.
He's just sitting on the back of Derek Nyquist stretching that quadriceps.
His IT bands must be screaming
oh
right
my
now.
God. I cannot imagine the pain that he is in right now. Especially
oh, he dropped it.
Oh,
he's
got an ankle. He's got an ankle.
He just hacked. His hand hit the mat. That's a tap.
I think it has to be more than one.
I don't think Pop saw it. And Gallo rolling it back. Going for the ankle lock and into a crowd. Oh, my God. Here comes Stretch Hand.
Oh, with the gamble clutch. What is this? Wow. Derek is not going to get up on that one, guys. I don't think so.
He's not going to be able to take much more.
I think Freak Squad's putting a number on Derek Nyquist.
He is not going to be able to take much more.
This just in, that move is called the Eiffel Tower, by the way.
The new champion is taking it to the former champion, that's for sure. Let him know that who's in the house. Down the bond, EXW Wrestler of the Year, showing why he is the
absolute best athlete going right now in EXW, but right now he's in a world of trouble.
That's Nyquist fighting back against Dom, getting those shots in the head, shots like that. I don't know how he just grabbed the hold of Derek's head like that. It looked like he stuck his fingers up his nose for a second.
Down the bond is trying to clean house. Look at this, here he goes.
Here comes down the top. Gallo setting him up. Here comes the big elbow drop.
It's over. If the ref turns around with the cover, that's it.
Here he goes.
Changes the Macho Man Randy Savage.
Derek Nyquist barely kicked out.
Change of the Macho Man Randy Savage.
Randy Savage. Randy Savage will be proud of Don Bob Vitale's elbow.
Wow.
Outstanding. Outstanding. And here comes Derek Nyquist. Oh, he locked it.
Good Lord, a DDT into the ground. Good Lord.
This is why,
with authority,
Dom is on Derek Nyquist's neck. Derek Nyquist's
neck is getting run. Dom is not moving too much. Dom needs to get over to his partner. Oh, wow, listen to the crowd, guys. The crowd's starting to go crazy here at the celebrity.
And here's the tag. Here comes Val. And there are Frenchie ducking, kicking, and he's scratching it. Caught.
He's like a tornado with teeth and ass. He's like a tornado with teeth and ass. Clean the house. Listen to the crowd going crazy, guys. This is nuts.
Oh, man, he catches the hook. Wow. That looked like a real low blow. Down and a neck breaker by Val Venus. Going for the cover. One, two. And oh, he dropped the elbow right on French's jaw. Man. Oh, I know it. Oh, that's so bad right now. Val Venus grabbing the hook down. Here comes the crowd.
Oh, wow! My God, Val Venus is on freaking fire!
Val Venus for war tonight, guys.
Fred Gene, God, like a Comanche war.
There's bodies all over the place right now. It looks like a train wreck happened in the room.
This is crazy.
Fred Gene didn't notice. He didn't notice, but John Bernard! Oh! Avalanche into the corner!
That's two big ball hairy men in the corner. Here comes Fred Gene.
He's going to eat it.
I don't know, you know, you guys, the crowd here right now.
He's back.